So good morning students, welcome back to our online classes. In the last video we have discussed the dot product of two vectors in the 8th chapter vector algebra 1. Okay, so in that we have discussed the definition for dot product, properties of dot product, and we have solved some of the examples. Okay, now we are going to start the exercises. After completing the exercises we will get back to the example problems, which problems are somewhat difficult. Okay, so in exercise 8.3 the first problem is left to you as exercise because it is very simple. You have to find dot product for two vectors. You know how to find dot product for two vectors. You have to take the corresponding components, that is numbers, and you have to multiply and add. Then you will get the value for the dot product, that is a number. Okay. So now we are going to see the second problem. What is the second problem? Find the value of lambda for which the vectors A vector and B vector are perpendicular, where A vector is equal to 2i cap plus lambda j cap plus k cap, and B vector is equal to i cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. Okay, so now the given information is the given two vectors are perpendicular. We know the definition, that is one important property, that if two vectors are perpendicular then their dot product is equal to 0. That is the thing we are going to make use of. Okay, so first let us take the two vectors. Let A vector is equal to 2i cap plus lambda j cap plus k cap. Then B vector is equal to I cap minus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. Now the given information for you is the given two vectors are perpendicular, that is A vector is perpendicular to B vector. From this you can take that A vector dot B vector is equal to 0. Now we are going to take dot product. Dot product means you have to multiply the corresponding numbers. Here the number is 2 and here the number is 1. So 2 into 1 is 2. Okay. Next, here the number is lambda, here it is minus 2. When you are multiplying these two numbers, you will get minus 2 lambda. Now, here the number is 3 and here the number is 1. So, 1 into 3 is plus 3, okay, which is equal to 0. Now, 2 plus 3 is 5, okay. So, you just bring the 2 lambda to the other side. So, 2 plus 3 is 5. When lambda goes to the other side, means you will get 2 lambda. From which we can able to find the value of lambda. So lambda is equal to 5 by 2. Okay, so this is the value of lambda. Now you are having another subdivision. The second subdivision, you just solve the problem by yourself. Okay, next we are going to see the fourth problem. Okay, third problem left to you as exercise. Find the angle between the vectors I cap minus j cap and j cap minus k cap. Already I have given the formula to find the angle between two vectors. Okay. So what is that formula? You can make use of the formula cos theta is equal to a vector dot b vector divided by modulus a vector modulus b vector. Okay. So now first let me name the vectors. Let us say A vector is equal to I cap minus J cap and B vector is equal to J cap minus K cap. Okay. Now let theta be the angle. Let theta be the angle between A vector and B vector. Okay. So now we know the formula. We know that what is the formula we know? Cos theta is equal to A vector or B vector divided by modulus A vector modulus B vector. Now we have to find the value A vector or B vector, then modulus of each vector. Now A vector dot B vector, which is equal to, you have to take dot product. Dot product means you have to multiply the corresponding numbers. Here the number is 1. but here you are not at all having I cap. You are not having I cap means the number is going to be 0. So 1 into 0, it will become 0. So just give that number. Next, the J cap number is minus 1. Here the number is 1. So minus 1 into 1 is nothing but minus 1. Next, here you are not having K cap. So you will take that 0 and here the number is minus 1. So 0 into minus 1 is 0. So you just leave it. So A vector and B vector is equal to minus 1. Then modulus of A vector. What is modulus of A vector? You have to square the numbers and add. When you are squaring and adding the numbers, 1 square plus minus 1 square, which is equal to 1 plus 1, which is equal to root 2. Okay. Now I am going to find the modulus for B vector, which is equal to, you have to square and add. So 1 square plus minus 1 square, which is equal to root 2. You just substitute all the values in the given formula. So what is that? Cos theta is equal to A vector dot B vector. What is A vector dot B vector? Minus 1. So minus 1 divided by modulus A vector modulus B vector. So when you are multiplying root 2 into root 2, you will get 2. Okay. So now, which implies that cos theta is equal to minus, you can write this as cos pi by 3, because cos 60 degree value is 1 by 2, so I have kept the number minus as it is. Now I am going to write this as pi minus pi by 3, that is cos of 180 minus theta is nothing but minus cos theta. This is the formula which I have introduced in the first class of trigonometry, that is cos of pi minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. Okay. So now when you are taking LCM for this, you will get that cos theta is equal to cos of, you have to take the LCM as 3, when you are cross multiplying this, 3 pi minus pi, which is nothing but 2 pi. So when you are cos and cos will get cancels, so that theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. So the angle between the given vectors is 2 pi by 3, that is 2 into 60 degree is nothing but 120 degree. Okay. So now we are going to see the fifth problem. What is the problem? If A vector, comma B vector, comma C vector are 3 vectors, such that A vector plus 2B vector plus C vector is equal to 0 vector, and modulus A vector equal to 3, modulus B vector equal to 4, modulus C vector equal to 7, and find the angle between A vector and B vector. So you are given with this condition. From this condition you have to find the angle between A vector and B vector. Okay. So first, let theta be the angle. Let theta be the angle between A vector and B vector. Okay. So now you just take the given condition. What is the given condition? A vector plus 2B vector plus C vector, which is equal to 0 vectors. Now we are going to find the angle between A and B. So you just keep A and B in the left hand side, you just bring the C vector to the right hand side. So what you will have? A vector plus 2B vector, which is equal to minus C vector. Next, we are going to square on both sides. So you just square on both sides. So squaring on both sides, what you will get? Modulus of A vector plus 2B vector square, which is equal to, when you square the minus it will become positive, so modulus C vector square. Okay. Now you just expand this using the formula A plus B the whole square. What is the formula? Modulus of A vector square plus, when you square the number you will get 4, then 4 into modulus of B vector square. Next thing, what is that? You just take the number out. Here you will have 2 and from this you are having another 2, so 2 into 2. Then when you take dot product, you will get the 2 into A vector dot B vector. Okay. this is the thing. So this dot stands for ordinary multiplication of numbers and this is dot product. Okay, so you take like this. Then which is equal to modulus of c vector square. Now we are having the values for all the vectors. Modulus a vector. What is modulus a vector? 3. When you are squaring this, you will get that 9. Plus what is modulus b vector? 4. When you are squaring this, you will get 16. Already you are having 4. So 16 into 4 is nothing but 64. Next step. 2 into 2 is 4. Now I am going to make use of the definition of dot product. Okay? What is the definition of dot product? A vector dot b vector is equal to modulus a vector modulus b vector into cos theta, which is equal to what is modulus a vector? 7. When you are squaring this, you will get 49. Okay? Then after that, when you are adding this number, what will you get? 64 plus 9 is 73. Okay, you have to bring that 73 to the other side. So which implies that 4 into, already we are having the value of modulus a vector. What is modulus a vector? 3 into, what is modulus b vector? 4 into cos theta, which is equal to 49 minus 73. 49 minus 73. Okay, so let me continue here. Now 4 into 3 is 12. 12 4s are 48. So 48 cos theta, which is equal to minus 24. So you are having cos theta is equal to minus 24 divided by 48. So cos theta is equal to minus 1 by 2. So just before, if cos theta equal to minus 1 by 2, I told the angle, how to find the angle. So from this directly you can write that theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. So the angle between a vector and the b vector is nothing but 2 pi by 3.